My name is Andrew Rich. I'm the Senior Director for the Biomedical Engineering Department for the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. So a biomedical technologist has several responsibilities. Their core responsibilities are performing repairs of both simple and complex medical devices, and then also performing preventive maintenance and inspection services on those devices to ensure that they're working properly and meeting manufacturer specifications. So the impact of the services that we provide in our organization here and others is significant. The medical devices that we support ultimately support the care of patients, whether it's a simple device or a life support, life-sustaining piece of equipment. Well, the career outlook for biomedical equipment technologists is significant. We're in high demand. As more and more technology is used in patient care, somebody needs to support that equipment. Somebody needs to know how it works. So starting salaries for biomedical technologists have really improved over the years as we have become more integrated into the healthcare system. An average starting salary for a technician would be in the mid-40s, somebody fresh out of school who's been in an internship. And depending on your skill set, if you're all the way up to a specialist in radiology, you could be making over six figures. So part of what I do is I'm an adjunct professor at a local university, and the first day of class, I put up a picture that I took out of our neonatal intensive care unit. This picture is of a very sick patient weighing probably only 900 grams. If you can think about that, a patient maybe about this small, in an environment with a multitude of medical devices supporting its life. And I put the picture up on the screen and I asked the students, can you find the patient? And can you figure out how many pieces of medical equipment are there? And more often than not, it takes maybe 5 or 6 minutes, they finally figure out where the patient is, but I have to lead them on. But usually the count of medical devices is incorrect. For this particular patient you're seeing on the screen, there were 42 different medical devices that were supporting this patient. The patient is in an infant warming system that's in the middle. You kind of see them covered a little bit in blankets. But my goal in showing that is to help students understand right off the bat that every piece of device, every medical device that you see there is contributing to keeping this patient alive and helping them hopefully get better and develop. And then every piece of equipment there we support. Whether it's the basic device that provides suction to the device that's providing ventilation to the patient, and everything in between. All of those devices, we have responsibility for supporting. We have responsibility to make sure that a clinician looks at that piece of equipment, they know it's working properly, the data they're receiving from that piece of equipment is accurate, so that they can make the right decisions on how to care for them, what kind of medications to give to that patient, what the next steps are in treating them.